Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you all are aware that we are reading chapter 6, Poets and the Pancakes by Ashoka Mitran. So before moving ahead, as it is the third video lesson on this lesson, so before moving ahead, let us recall what we have read in last two video lessons, what we have discussed in last two video lessons. So we have seen that this story is about Gemini Studios, in which Ashoka Mitran also used to be a part. He was working in Gemini Studios. Ashoka Mitran tells us how film making was done during 1940s. Most of the films used to be shot indoors. Only 5% of the films used to be shot outdoors. Ashoka Mitran also tells that how his work was considered an insignificant work by other members of Gemini Studios. One by one, Ashoka Mitran tells us about everyone who were working in Gemini Studios. Ashoka Mitran tells us that first, Gemini Studio belonged to a Bengali. But later, when Bengali became rich and when he thought that running a studio did not suit him, then he left. And later, now Gemini Studios was owned by a Maharashtrian. So people from different background, different religion, from different parts of the country used to work there. That is why Ashoka Mitran calls it, national integration. He said that national integration could be seen in Gemini Studios before it had started telecasting on AIR, on All India Radio and Doordarshan. Further, one by one, he continues giving us introduction about the poets, about the actors, about office boy. So finally, he comes to a very important person of Gemini Studio whose name was Kothmangalam Subbu. So let's see what he talks about Kothmangalam Subbu. As he tells us about Kothmangalam Subbu, that Kothmangalam Subbu had to play a very important role in Gemini Studios. He had solution to every problem. Whenever producer would ask him for shooting any scene, he comes with many solutions. As he was asked that how to shoot this scene, the rat fights the tigress underwater and kills her, but takes pity on the cubs and tends them lovingly. When producer would say so, producer would ask Subbu. Subbu came with four solutions, but when the producer was not was not satisfied with those four solutions, after that he came out with 14 more solutions. So overall, Kothmangalam Subbu was very important in Gemini Studios, as He was the man of principles. He had solution to every problem. Okay. So let's see what happened next. Further, what writer tells us about him. He was tailor-made for films. Tailor-made means made or adopted. Tailor-made. So he was made for films. Here was a man who could be inspired when commanded. The rat fights with the tigress underwater and kills her, but takes pity on the cubs and tends them lovingly. I don't know how to do the scene, the producer would say. And Subbu would come out with four ways of the rat powering affection on the victim's offspring. Offspring means child. Yesterday I made you write these words and their meanings, and we discussed two. During revision also we discussed. So now let us start reading from page number 61. Second paragraph. You saw Subbu always with the boss, but in the attendance roles, he was grouped under a department called the story department, comprising a lawyer and an assembly of writers and poets. So further, Ashoka Mitran tells us that one can see Subbu always with the boss, but in the attendance roles, but during attendance, in the attendance sheet or during attendance, he was grouped under a department called the story department. He was grouped under the department which called story department. So he was counted in the story department, comprising a lawyer and an assembly of writers and poets. Story department comprising a lawyer and an assembly of writers and poets. The lawyer was also officially known as the legal advisor, but everybody referred to him as the opposite. The lawyer was also officially known as the legal advisor. The lawyer was famous. Officially he was known as legal advisor, but everybody referred to him opposite. Though they were referring him opposite, others in the examining studios, as he was officially he was considered a legal advisor, a lawyer, but people, they did not think so. They think just opposite to it. The lawyer was also officially known as the legal advisor, and everybody referred to him as the opposite. An extremely talented actress who was also extremely temperamental means liable to unreasonable change of mood. Temperamental means liable to unreasonable change of unreasonable. Let me show you. Yes. Now you can take the screenshot. Just wait a minute. Unreasonable change of mood. One more word, incriminating. Okay, we will discuss later. I'll make you write. So, an extremely talented actress who was also extremely temperamental. So, there was an extremely talented actress who was also extremely, you know, always, who could unreasonably, she could change her mood. Once blew over on the sets. Once she started shouting, she became angry on the sets. While everyone stood quietly or stood shocked, the lawyer quietly switched on the recording equipment. She was struck down. So at this, that actress was struck down. A girl from the countryside, she hadn't gone through all the stages of worldly experience that generally precede, there was nothing incriminating of unmentionably foul about the actress track. So let me write down some words and their meanings now from this thing, then I'll continue the explanation. Making someone appear. Appear guilty of crime. Tirade. Next word. Tirade means a long angry speech of criticism. A long angry speech of criticism. Okay, please note down these words. Either you may pause the video or write them down, or you may take a screenshot. Let me rub them and write some more difficult words and their meanings from this page, page number 61.
sophistication. Sophistication, having a good understanding of the way people behave. Having a good understanding of the way having a good understanding of the way people behave, that is sophistication. Next word, unwittingly. Unwittingly means unknowingly. Unwittingly means unknowingly. Unwittingly means unknowingly. Okay, next word. Ketchup tilted. Ketchup tilted. Ketchup tilted means move suddenly or at great speed. Either you may pause the video and write them down, or you may take the screenshot and write later. Let us proceed. Proceed means come before. Proceed means come before. Okay, now let us continue. So an extremely talented actress who was also extremely temperamental, who was also liable to unreasonable change of mood. She could change her mood anytime. Okay, she was short tempered. Once blew over on the sets while everyone stood stunned, while everyone stood shocked, the lawyer quietly switched on the recording equipment. When the actress paused for breath, the lawyer said to her, 1 minute please. So one actress paused for breath. So the lawyer asked her, 1 minute please, and played back the recording. And he started playing back the recording which he recorded during when she was angry, during her anger. Okay. And he played back the recording. There was nothing incriminating or unmentionably foul about the actress tried against the producer. So there was nothing incriminating. Incriminating. There was nothing which you know making a wrongdoing. So there was nothing which could provoking her for this wrongdoing. And unmentionably foul about actress tried, and she delivered a long speech of criticism to the producers. But when she heard the voice again through the sound equipment, she was dumbstruck. So during, when she was angry, she was delivering a lecture to the producer in her anger. So when she once again heard back the same sound, then she became dumbstruck. A girl from worldly experience that generally precede a position of importance and sophistication that she had found herself catapulted into. So the girl, a girl from the countryside, she hadn't gone through all the stages of worldly experience. She had no experience of the world. She was a girl, so she was at her early age. She had just entered in this world. She came before a position of importance and sophistication that she had found herself catapulted into. She found herself that she had moved among the people who are very experienced. She never quite recovered from the terror she felt that day. She never came out of the terror which she felt that day. So that was the end of the brief and brilliant acting career. It was the end of that the girl's small acting career. The legal advisor, who was also a member of story department. So this legal advisor, this lawyer, who was also the part of story department, had unwittingly brought about that end. So he unknowingly brought that end. He unknowingly ended the career of that girl. It was very short career of that girl. She had just started her career, but because of this incident, she never, she was not a part of any film after that. She never played any role in any film after this incident, which was done by the lawyer only, who was considered the legal advisor of the story department, who was also the member of story department. While every other member of department wore a kind of uniform khadi dhoti with a slightly oversized and clumsily tailored white khadi shirt. So the member of story department, they used to wear khadi dhoti, which was slightly oversized and clumsily tailored white khadi shirt. The legal advisor wore pants and a tie and sometimes coat that looked like a coat of mail. So sometimes other members of story department, they used to wear this shirt and khaki shirt and dhoti. On the other hand, the legal advisor, the lawyer, he used to wear a shirt and tie, and sometimes he also wearing a coat which was like the coat of a postman. So here mail has been used for a postman. Often he looked alone and helpless, a man of cold logic in a crowd of dreamers. So often he looked alone because he was the man of logic in the crowd of dreamers. So crowd of dreamers means, you know, all the members of the Gemini Studios, they did not come there to do the job which they had been given. Everyone wanted to be either actor or singer, but unfortunately they had been given some small work in the Japanese studios. They could not fulfill their dream. A neutral man is an assembly of Gandhis and Khadis. When an assembly of Gandhis and Khadis, an assembly of Gandhians and Khadis, he was a lone man. Like so many of those who were close to the boss, he was allowed to produce a film, and through a lot of raw stock and pancake were used on it. So he was also allowed to produce a film in which a lot of stock of pancakes had been used for makeup. Not much came of the film, but the film was not a successful one. Then one day the boss closed down the story department, and this was perhaps the only instance in all human history where a lawyer lost his job because the poets were asked to go home. Okay, so one day the boss decided to close the story department. The decision of closing down the story department was taken, and all the poets, they went home. They were asked to go home, while the lawyer, this is the first time in human history where in a humorous way Ashoka Mithran said, this is the first time in human history when a lawyer lost his job. Okay, so we have seen, dear student, this is very interesting lesson. It is about Japanese studios. It tells us about the different members and different parts of Japanese studios. At the same time, we can also imagine how, in the same way, there are many parts in a film production company, and every department has to play a major role in making of a film. Only then a film successfully shot. A film is successfully shot. So Ashoka Mithran not only tells about the people who was working in Germany studios, he was also sharing with us what was the working culture those days in any film production company. So with help of this example of Germany studios, we are able to know how in 1940s the film production was done. And in the same way, he also tells us the nature of some people who were working there, as he tells us about Kothmangalam Subbu, who was the man of principle, who himself did not do anything, but for others he had a lot of work. And also Ashoka Mithran tells us about Kothmangalam Subbu's personal life, how kind person he was. About dozen of people used to stay, from relatives and from friends, they used to stay at his home. He used to serve them. So he used to show a great hospitality towards them. Kothmangalam Subbu was considered next to boss. Here Ashoka Mithran also made a remark that Kothmangalam Subbu was such a kind person, even though he had enemies. Okay, so here Ashoka Mithran not only tells us about the studio, he also tells us about the nature of different people. Okay, so one by one he describes about all the artists, all the poets, all the members of Gemini Studios, and he also makes a remark of human beings, the way we behave in real life. So it's all about this video lesson. In my next video lesson, I'll explain the remaining part of this lesson. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.